Hello, this is Jake from the Corona team, and in the next few minutes, you'll be able to use Chaos Scanner to create natural environments like this. Chaos Scanner is a powerful system that allows us to control the distribution of grass, trees, and much more. We can create a scatter object from the Corona menu. Distribute on is the surface object where we want to distribute our foliage. So in this case, let's choose this mountain. An instance model is the object we want to distribute. And we can just drag and drop one of our trees in here. And we can see this has now been scattered across our mountain. Under surface scattering, we can see the count. And this is the number of instances that are created. We can increase or decrease the number to make the forest sparser or denser. When dealing with steep geometry, slope limitation is a really useful feature of scatter. This is going to dictate where trees can grow based on the angle of the surface they're on. So let's switch this to world, and currently at 180 degrees, the trees will grow everywhere. And as we lower the amount, so does the area where the trees can grow. Now let's add some trees to our island. Create another scatter object, and this time select the island. And then drag and drop our trees onto the scatter. Now we've got a lot of trees on our island, so let's bring the count down to 200. We can see that some of our trees are intersecting. Turning on avoid collisions, we can now see that none of the trees' bounding boxes are touching. So when on 100%, none of the bounding boxes will touch. Whereas if we lower the amount, the objects can overlap and this will make a denser forest. By default, the trees will use the normal of the surface they're on to dictate the angle they're pointing. Using the normal alignment, we can change this. And by putting in 1, we're now using the world's normal. So notice now that all our trees are pointing up. So our forest is looking pretty good, but our trees currently look very similar. We can use the translation to randomize the height of the start of the trees. So if we make this translation anywhere between minus 100 to 0, we can see the start of some of our trees lowers. Notice that the rotation is on 360. And if we make it 0, you can see that all the trees would face in the same direction. So 360 is what we'd want for a forest. The scale will also add more variation to the scale of our object. And if we make it between 80 and 120%, then the tree will be anywhere between 80 and 120% of the original object size. We can optimize our scenes using camera clipping, and this means only objects within our camera's field of view will be scattered. We can adjust the extend view to create an extra zone beyond the field of view, and by turning this up, we can ensure that we get the correct shadows and reflections. Cosmos is a great place to find trees and vegetation to scatter, but along with these are scatter presets. We can find these in Cosmos under presets, and all we need to do is select the preset we want to use, import it, and then select our distribute on object. And let's add camera clipping to this as well. Another powerful feature of scatter is the ability to use splines to dictate where to scatter or not. And we can find the spline include and exclude under areas, add a spline to the exclude to create a path, and we can use the near and far distances to control the width and the fall off of our path. So if we make our near 50 centimeters and our far 200 centimeters, we'll add some fall off. We can also add the same spline to our tree scatter to exclude any trees from our path. If we wanted to have flowers just in one patch, then we could use an include. So we can create a scatter, add the flowers, and distribute on the island. And under include, let's just select a circle. And we can also up the count. Chaos Scatter allows us to distribute objects and get them placed exactly how we want using straightforward tools. And remember, trees and grass aren't the only things we can scatter. Cars, buildings, and even decals can be distributed using scatter. We look forward to seeing what you create, and make sure to check out our other videos to keep exploring what Corona can do for you.